Let's discuss the pressure distribution in an accelerated frame. As we already studied that in a static fluid, free surface of fluid is always normal to effective acceleration acting on it. This we already studied, and let's have a look on the physical situation. We can see here in this figure A, we can see that we are having a container which is placed in gravity, and say G is acting in downward direction, and the free surface of liquid is normal to G. And at any point, say we consider a point A which is at a depth H below, the free surface of liquid layer pressure at point A can be directly written as P atmosphere plus H rho G. This we have discussed several times. Now, let us consider a situation in which the container will start moving towards right with an acceleration A. If the container will start moving towards right with an acceleration A, the whole fluid body will experience a pseudo acceleration in backward direction or a pseudo force M in backward direction. Or we can say the body will be experiencing an effective acceleration in backward direction, G in downward direction, due to which the free surface of liquid now no longer be horizontal. And the resulting situation here we can see, here in figure P, the resulting situation is shown. And you can see if the container starts moving toward right with an acceleration A, every medium particle of the fluid will experience a pseudo acceleration or effective acceleration A in opposite direction, and G it is experiencing in downward direction. So the resulting acceleration acting on it will be G effective, and it is in this direction. If we just draw the vector diagram here again, here G is acting in downward direction, effective acceleration on the fluid is in leftward direction. So resulting acceleration of the fluid will be G effective, it will act in this direction, and automatically the free surface of liquid is adjusted in such a way that it is normal to the effective acceleration acting on it. In this situation, this effective acceleration can be written as the two accelerations are normal to each other, it can be written as root of A square plus G square. And the angle, if we wish to find out between effective acceleration and vertical, is theta. The same as the angle between the free surface of liquid with the horizontal, this theta can be easily given as tan inverse of A by G. You should also keep both of these things in your mind, and you can see whenever a container is accelerated with an acceleration A, we can directly state that the free surface of liquid within the container will become inclined in such a way that its angle with the horizontal is tan inverse of A by G. If A is the horizontal acceleration of the container. In the next slide, let's discuss about the pressure distribution in this accelerated container. Let us discuss about pressure distribution in the same accelerated container, in which the free surface of liquid will become inclined at an angle theta, where theta is given as tan inverse of A by G, which we already studied. Now, in this situation, if we wish to find out the pressure at a point A within the fluid body, then we need to take its depth below the free surface of liquid along the effective acceleration, say this depth is H. Then directly pressure at point A can be given as the pressure acting on the free surface by atmosphere is P atmospheric. So we can simply write as P atmospheric plus H rho G effective, which can be written as root of G square plus A square, that is the pressure at point A. This is one method to find out the pressure at point A, and there is one more way by which we can calculate the pressure at point A, by using the pressure variation along the direction of gravity as well as along the direction of effective horizontal acceleration acting on the fluid due to the motion or due to the acceleration of container. Let's see that also. Now, the alternative way to find out the pressure at point A is by using pressure variation along the gravity or along the pseudo acceleration acting on the fluid which is in the container which is accelerating towards right. Now, say point A is at a depth H1 vertically below the free surface of the liquid. Here we can say along the vertical length or vertical height H1, there won't be any pressure variation due to this acceleration as this will be normal to the acceleration. And at this point, pressure acting by atmosphere is P atmospheric. So at point A, pressure can also be given as P atmospheric plus H1 rho G. Here we won't take G effective like we have taken in this expression. Because in vertical direction, pressure is only varying due to gravity. Similarly, if this point A is taken a horizontal distance L from the free surface, again we can say at the free surface, pressure acting is P atmospheric. So, pressure at point A can be given as P atmospheric plus L rho A, because along the length of L, the pressure is only varying due to the effective acceleration A as due to gravity there won't be any variation along the length L as it is horizontal and due to gravity no variation of pressure exists here. So there are three ways and directly we can find out the pressure at point A. One is along the effective gravity which we have just now taken. Other is along the vertical and the third one is along the length L. So, you just need to take care of all these cases whenever required, we can use any of these.